One pixel is the smallest controllable element of an image. We see billions of them every day, but this was not always the case. In the adolescence of the digital age, every pixel was precious. A single dot could be the eye of a space invader or the bouncing ball in Breakout. Each pixel was a necessary contribution to the mosaic of the screen. As our technology has grown, so has the desire for better graphics with improved resolution. It seems the individual pixel has been all but forgotten. Still, there are those of us who remember the power of the pixel and are using a classic medium to bring them back to life, not digitally, but here in the real world.
Welcome to my studio. I'm Kyle McCoy, and for the past several years, I've been using Perler beads to create a variety of different kinds of artwork, including detailed portraits, minimalist pixel art, and some pretty big murals, and much, much more. This series is going to take a look at what goes into creating this kind of artwork, but the most important thing to remember is that it always starts with an idea.
Imagine, design, execute, assemble. The four steps I always seem to follow.
Perler beads are the perfect medium for video game artwork, so let's start simple with some patterns that anyone can find online. And what better subject matter for our first episode than the game that was the first appearance of Mario? I'm talking about Donkey Kong!
Donkey Kong was an arcade machine released by Nintendo in 1981. Back then, Mario was called Jumpman, and the woman on top, since called Pauline, was originally named Lady. Yes, we've got Jumpman, Lady, and a monkey named Donkey.
Monkeys aren't donkeys! Quit messing with my head!
Its creator, Shigeru Miyamoto, got his inspiration from Popeye, Beauty and the Beast, and King Kong, which is weird because that movie came out in 2005.
Alright, first we need to come up with a plan in our head.
Imagine it.
Today we're making the iconic image of Donkey Kong sitting at the top of the screen doing barrel rolls.
Do a barrel roll!
Not that kind of barrel roll. Silly rabbit.
I like Spriter's Resource, a great website for finding video game-based patterns. Here's the sheet we'll be needing. It's got it all. Donkeys, platforms, barrels. I just noticed it says these sprites were ripped by Xeon, who wants his due credit. We thank you, Xeon.
Alright, is it time to put the beads on the board already?
Design it.
These are the pegboards I'll be working on. They have these nifty parts on the side so they can interlock for large projects like this. Donkey was originally this solid rust color, but I'm gonna use some realistic browns instead.
Just because they were limited in their color selection in 1981, doesn't mean we need to be.
Never give up! Trust your instincts!
That's enough, Peppy. He's right, though.
I'll finish him off with tan and white, with bubblegum and raspberry for the platforms.
Stop! Hammer time.
Nice! Last chance to make any changes, because the next step is permanent.
Execute it.
Time to commit to your final design, because the heat from this iron is going to cause your beads to melt or fuse into each other. There are many methods and techniques when it comes to ironing, but for now, we're just going to cover the basics.
Gently place your ironing paper on top of your work. Start ironing on one side, working your way over in a circular motion. You'll be able to see the beads melting through the paper, so keep an eye on them to make sure they melt evenly. Flip it over and do the other side to make it extra sturdy. Now while your piece is cooling, I'd recommend putting some big books on top to help keep it flat. I'll be using the complete works of William Shakespeare.
Because that's some heavy stuff, man. Mercutio? Am I right?
After a few minutes, it will be ready for handling.
Grrr.
Now let's make those barrels. What's this word all about? Well, this Donkey Kong piece is actually just part of an even larger piece, but more on that later. Time for the final step.
Assemble it.
Whip out your trusty hot glue gun and give each perler piece a few dollops of... Dollops is a word, right? Yeah, okay. A few dollops of glue before applying it to the canvas. Careful to line up the edges. A little black foam core will raise this barrel, giving us a 3D effect. Put a fork in him because he's done. Don't really, it's just an expression.
What wonderful things beads are! There's something immensely satisfying about creating a solid work of art like this. The time and the care that go into it are obvious. And it's not as fragile as a drawing or a painting. No, this is hands-on. This can be touched. In fact, perler beads are so sturdy they can be used to create magnets, jewelry, coasters, and more. I'll be releasing a new video every day this week as we continue to discuss tips and tricks, along with one of my favorite games. See you then.